Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Welcome to the October 4th regular meeting of your Board of Commissioners. We're meeting tonight at the Vera Holland Community Center in Stoneville. We appreciate everyone who is in attendance tonight. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Tonight, we'll start off with our invocation given by Minister Reverend Nancy Redd. And she's with the SHARON Missionary Baptist Church. And while we're standing, if able, please continue to stand. And the Pledge of Allegiance will be given to us by led by Jay Rainey. So if you will, come on up, Ms. Redd, and stand at the podium. I'll stand if you're able.
Chairman Hall, the rest of the elected officials tonight, to our all elected officials, to our law enforcement, and to the citizens of Rockingham County. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to give the invocation. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this day, a beautiful day that you made for us, that we have seen, but we will never see again. We thank you, God, today for our elected officials that you have so elected. God, we thank you. We ask you tonight to give them wisdom, give them knowledge. And God, we ask you to help them to bring that together, that we all would have a better understanding of how to live in Rockingham County. We thank you tonight, God, for our law enforcement who is here tonight. Keep them, God, and shield them and protect them. And God, at the end of the day, help them to make decisions, God, that will influence, that will keep, that will bring peace, that will bring understanding to all those here in Rockingham County. Bless us, keep us, and take care of us. For it's in your Son's name we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Reverend. Mr. Rainey.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Be seated. Tonight we have the opportunity to hear a proclamation recognizing and commemorating the 76th anniversary of National Disability Employment Awareness Month in Rockingham County. I'll ask our assistant county manager if he would read that.
So, proclamation recognizing and commemorating the 76th anniversary of National Disability Employment Awareness Month in Rockingham County. Whereas October 2021 marks the 76th anniversary of National Disability Employment Awareness Month, and whereas the purpose of National Disability Employment Awareness Month is to educate about disability employment issues and celebrate the many and varied contributions of America's workers with disabilities, and whereas the history of National Disability Employment Awareness Month traces back to 1945, where Congress enacted a law declaring the first week in October each year National Employed Physically Handicapped Week, and whereas in 1962, the word physically was removed to acknowledge the employment needs and contributions of individuals with all types of disabilities. And whereas in 1988, Congress expanded the week to a month and changed the name to National Disability Employment Awareness Month. And whereas workplaces that are welcoming of the talents of all people, including people with disabilities, are a critical part of our efforts to build an inclusive community and strong economy. And whereas activities during this month will reinforce the value and talent people with disabilities add to our workplace and communities and affirm Rockingham County's commitment to an inclusive community that increases access and opportunities to all, including individuals with disabilities. Therefore, be it resolved that Rockingham County recognizes and commemorates the 76th anniversary of National Disability Employment Awareness Month, and that the county call upon employers, schools, and other community organizations in Rockingham County to observe October with appropriate programs and activities, and to advance its important message that people with disabilities add value and talent to our workplaces and communities, and pledge to continue to take steps throughout the year to recruit, hire, retain, and advance individuals with disabilities, and work to pursue the goals of opportunity, full participation, economic self-sufficiency, and independent living for people with disabilities. This is the fourth day of October 2021.
Thank you. Appreciate that. With that, we will entertain a motion to accept or affirm that proclamation.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Commissioner Travis. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Commissioner Powell. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Thank you very much. We appreciate the opportunity to do that. With that, we move to the approval of our October 4th agenda. Gentlemen, are there any changes to our agenda that you're aware of? Otherwise, we'll accept a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, Commissioners Richardson and Burton. With that, we have a motion on the floor to accept. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Thank you. With that, we have our consent agenda. Now, items on the consent agenda are non-controversial items. However, if anyone has a question about those, our county manager, or tonight in this case, our assistant county manager, would be glad to answer questions on those details. Are there any items that members want to remove from the consent agenda? With that, we'll accept a motion to accept the consent agenda.
So moved.
Thank you, Commissioner Powell.
Second.
Thank you, Commissioner Travis. We have a motion and a second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Thank you very much, gentlemen. With that brings us to public comment. And tonight we have three folks signed up to speak. So I'll ask our assistant county manager again if he will read the guidelines for public comment. We're going to limit folks to 3 minutes, but Mr. Assistant Manager.
So the public comment period shall be for the purpose of allowing members of the public to present any matters pertaining to county business or items on the Board of Commissioners agenda. This period shall not serve as a forum for debate with the Board of Commissioners. Remarks shall be addressed directly to the Board of Commissioners and not to staff, the audience, or media. The chairperson shall open the public comment period. Any speaker who wishes to speak shall approach the podium and not speak from his or her seat. Each speaker shall clearly state his or her name and physical address when he or she approaches the podium. Any citizen desiring to present any matter concerning the services, policies, and affairs of Rockingham County shall be allotted 3 minutes. Citizens will be allowed to yield their time on a specific topic by utilizing one or more attendees' time. This would allow no more than 6 minutes. Your time will be displayed. We will keep up with it since our monitor's not here. If you are to yield time or time is yielded to you, then please let the chairman know in advance. Speakers appearing before the Board of Commissioners will not be allowed to campaign for public office, promote private business ventures, or use language of a personal nature which insults or demeans any person, of which, when directed at a public official, is not related to his or her official duties. The Board of Commissioners may accept written comments in lieu of oral statements, and written statements can be delivered to the county manager's office.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate that. That being said, our first person to speak tonight will be Bobby Stanley. Please approach the podium and give us your name and address, sir. Bobby Stanley is a former county commissioner.
Okay, Bobby R. Stanley, 628 Gun Road, Stoneville, North Carolina, 27408. I want to add one thing, that Pledge of Allegiance, that under God was put in there with the White Eisenhower when he was president. And I just want to mention that. A lot of people don't know it. And I want to, this month of the 24th of October is World Polio Day. And in 1980, 7.5 million Brazil children were vaccinated in one day. 24th. If that was the day, you'd have a hard time getting a million vaccinated. I just want to put that there. Okay, that's not all to be said about that. we're going back to economics in Stoneville. I grew up in this town. I grew up right here at this golf course. Carried newspapers here. I got up at 4 o'clock in the morning to get that paper out off so I could make it to school in time. I had about 100 in the morning, a little over 40, 41 in the afternoon. Wore out 2 brand new swing bicycles. And this little town at that time had about 3 restaurants, had 5 tobacco warehouses, Stoneville furniture down here at one time. It was 850 people working there. And you had Baxter Kelly. It was good economic activity here. In 2001, when China became a WTO member, everything left you just like a bully. The whole county's like that. And Milton Perlock was modernizing this factory down here in the 1990s. You see it now what it looks like. I don't know how many million it spent. He didn't live long after it closed down. I guess it had a whole lot of word in the day. And in Eden, North Carolina, I think I'm right with Carolina Woolen Mills, in August 1933, there were 6,323 people working there. I think that turned into Fieldcrest, I'm not sure, or Marshall Field. But this county had 6 governors that come from it. The last one losing the Hodges. This county was probably the top 10 economic counties in the state at one time. This was a very important county. And through what's happening in economics, it's all slipped a whole lot instead of a bunch. I was on that board when Haynes Brand left. 720 jobs, $200,000 in taxes. American Express is over on 68. They sold our plant for $31,500,000. Listen, they give all less than a million. They had 900,000 square foot. What a difference 40 miles could make. We need an economy right here in Stoneville. This park's over here. Goes from Mid-Am all the way to Virginia Line beyond. We need to encourage someone in Raleigh to start doing something. I know what they're doing. They're trying to get it linked together. They can fix part of it, some walking trails or campgrounds or something to get some commercial activity. 2 and 4 cents in sales tax stays in this county. 4 cents to the community college, 2 cents to the municipality, county, or whatever, how it's divided up. That's $22,500,000 per million, or $22,500 per million dollars. It amounts to a whole lot. It exceeds most of the time property tax. All we got left now is Dollar General. We got Rex over here. We got the bank and drugstore. The drugstore don't pay sales tax. Got a couple of stores. For them, there'd be nothing left yet. My daughter Samaya, she's doing her best. Managing all. We need some activity. Seems like the state park might be the best avenue. We can just get people to come to Stoneville. Maybe we get another restaurant. Maybe we get another retail business and things to generate a little bit of capital. I stayed in the county long enough to know there's 2 ways you pay the bills. One of them, you raise taxes. The other one, you grow your tax base enough to offset the raises and expense. And we need to do a little growing so we can do that up here. And my time's running out, right? Okay, thank y'all very much. Now I want to say one more thing before I sit down. We had a good fall festival. The circumstances, it was super good. And we appreciate all the publicity. The county did help on this some. And we appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Stanley. Yep. We appreciate you being here tonight. Next on the list is Curtis Pierce. Please come to the podium. Give us your name and address, sir.
I'm Curtis Pierce, 118 Laurel Drive, Eden, North Carolina. I'm from American Legion Post 254, and I'm here to tell you some general information about something that's going to be happening in Eden, and that's the bringing of the Vietnam Traveling Wall that we brought 8 years ago. It was a 50% replica of the one in Washington. The one we're bringing this time is an 80% replica. It's as long as a football field. I just want to give you a couple ideas of who all is. Not just Vietnam wall. Let me tell you what I was covering on this particular wall that we're bringing in here. And this wall is called The Cost of Freedom and the Tributes. It's a 911 tribute on there. World War I, World War II, Korea, the Cold War, the Iran hostage, Panama invasion, Desert Storm, Desert Shield, USS Cole attack, and the Fort Hood attack, plus several others. I'm not going to keep going through the whole list, but just to let you know, it's more than just the Vietnam Traveling Wall. It covers a lot of territory, and it covers all the people probably in Rockingham County that has been involved in the military or been in a war, going all the way back to World War I. So that's an important thing. We're having a parade of that wall coming in. We're gathering at Lowe's in Reesville at 3 o'clock on Wednesday, the 13th of October. We will parade that wall all the way into Eden, up Highway 14, down to Freedom Park. That's where it will be set up at, Freedom Park in Eden. We will put the wall up the next morning, the 14th, at 8 o'clock that morning. Hopefully, we'll have it up by lunchtime at 1 o'clock. After that, everybody or anybody is welcome to come view the wall. The wall is there until Sunday afternoon, the 17th at 3 o'clock. And we will take it back down on the 17th at 3 o'clock. The wall is available for viewing 24 hours a day. We'll have people there the whole time. If you want to go out there and trace the name off of that wall, we'll have the stuff there for you to do that. But it's going. This is a big thing for us. It's an expensive thing. This particular traveling wall is coming from Texas, and it's going to be a nice thing for Eden and also for Rockingham County. I'm very excited about it. I'm glad to be a part of it, and thank you for letting me speak.
Thank you, Mr. Pierce. Appreciate you being here tonight as well. And the last on our list is Johnny Farmer. Mr. Farmer, please approach the podium. Give us your name and address, sir.
Thank you, Chairman Hall. My name is Johnny Farmer. I live at 104 Pine Cone Drive in Stoneville, North Carolina. I serve as a town council member. And I just wanted to thank Rockingham County for doing your traveling show that you do in the summertime. I think it's great that you go to different areas of the county, which may not be able to come to your council meetings or when you're having them at Wentworth. So thank you for being in Stoneville. We're very well represented here in Stoneville today. We have our mayor, we have our town manager, we have our police department. So we want to thank all y'all for coming here, for supporting Stoneville. And Mr. Stanley was very, very wise in what he said a while ago. At one time, Stoneville was a very big powerhouse here in Rockingham County. We had a lot of business going on, and we feel like that we're still a powerhouse in Rockingham County here in Stoneville. We just want to continue to support you. We want the county to continue to support Stoneville, and we appreciate y'all being here, and again, thank y'all for coming to Stoneville.
Thank you, Mr. Farmer. Thank you for being here tonight. With that completes our public comment period. We have no one else signed up. With that, Mr. Murray, do we have any new business?
Yes, sir.
With that, we'll go to commissioner comments, and we'll ask Commissioner Powell.
So I'd just like to say thank you for coming out tonight.
Me,
yeah. Yeah, I was thinking he was
that threw me off a little bit. He usually calls me first.
I want to thank you for the opportunity to come up here. Stoneville is a powerhouse. I like this area very much. I worked up here as a deputy and as a detective from time to time, and in my business I work up here. So like Stoneville, I would like to tell you that there is economic development going on in Rockingham County. And hopefully that pushes its way to Stoneville as well. 85% of the total investment in Rockingham County has been made in the last 2 years. So we are getting economic development. There's a lot of good things coming here. There's a lot of growth that's coming here. We look forward to that, and we look forward to hoping that it moves up into this area as well, because it looks like it's kind of south of you right now, down in Madison and in the Mayaland area. So hang on. I think it's coming if we can keep the momentum going. We certainly have good people working on that. Very proud of our economic development team, commissioners for what they've done, and set on the economic development committee. And so I know there's been a lot of work done on that. So we hope that Stoneville will not only be a powerhouse in our minds, but be a powerhouse economically as well in the coming years. And once again, thank you for being well represented here. I see a lot of people I know and work with in law enforcement, as a matter of fact. So it's always good to be here, and thank you for your comments.
Thank you, Commissioner Powell. Commissioner Travis.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Bobby, I agree with you. I've tried for a couple of years to try to get someone from Stoneville area to actually be part of economic development in the county. I hope we can still work towards something like that. I know Eaton's got economic development director, Reason's got a mass meeting, so hopefully we can get someone to represent Stoneville too. I'm pretty positive we don't have nobody on the board from Stoneville. So that's something we can work on, Mayor, to try to get someone that represents Stoneville on that board. That's just a thought, you know. Mr. Pierce, thank you so much for bringing it to your attention. I had it on my notes to bring it up, but I hope you reach out to the schools and hopefully some of our school board members here, because it's history and it needs to be taught. If you don't learn history, you forget it. So it's very important that I hope you reach out to the papers and the schools to let the students and everybody in the county know. I hope the county can work with you too about maybe putting something on our Facebook page about it, because it's very important, because you know I'm a veteran, you got another veteran on the board, so I'm hoping to be there. I hope to be there. But with that, thank you, Stoneville, for hosting us today. I appreciate everybody coming out. Saturday, we had a great turnout at our outdoor youth hunting and gun safety day over in Riesel. We had 147 kids aged 3 and up that came out to participate. It was a great showing. We had some great, wonderful volunteers. We even had high school students that showed up to volunteer. And it was kind of sad that I only had one school board member there, because it is teaching and educating our kids. I wish more were there. But let me say, I want to thank Sheriff Page for being there. Our North Carolina House Representative Reese Pirtle was there. Doug Isley from the school board was there. Chris Freeman, one of our judges, showed up. So it was a great showing. I know it's very hard for a county our size to get information out there. And I think the county has been struggling for years to try to get information to this big county. And I encourage everyone to get on the county's Facebook page. We put a lot of information there. Get on our website every now and then. We put information there. We have a new public information officer, Rebecca Pegram, that I think is going to do great. So I need your help in Stoneville. I need your help in Madison, all over the place, to spread the word, because so much wonderful things happen like the wall that we need to spread the word, because we need to take care of the county before we worry about other counties. So I really appreciate that, and thank y'all for coming. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Commissioner Travis. Commissioner Richards.
Well, my appreciation to Stoneville. Stoneville, near and dear to my heart. This is where I used to sell tobacco and buy tractor parts down from Rake Straw Ford. Lots of friends over here. Bobby should have said something about Southern Finishing and Charlie Soap. I don't know there how many folks they have hired, but they're significant. And I know for a fact something's coming your way. And in the meantime, I can guarantee you'll be treated well when you come to the town of Stoneville. It's just full of welcoming people, including SHARON Baptist Church, Missionary Baptist Church. Certainly enjoyed everything. So thank you for having us. You have a long history, too, that is a significant part of the county's history. Some very old buildings and history that goes back quite a way.
small caution, it's fall. The leaves will be falling soon. And when the leaves fall, sometimes trash and litter that we haven't seen suddenly becomes visible. So an excuse to re-emphasize keeping litter off of Rockingham County and the various municipality highways and byways. And you'll notice some pink around the room, and I believe we'll be talking more about that at our next meeting, but if you would help the American Cancer Society recognize Breast Cancer Awareness Month through the month of October. I want to correct Commissioner Travis about forgetting the history. I believe Mr. Churchill's statement was you're condemned to repeat it if you don't know about it and you don't study it in the first part. So a good caution. Thank you, Travis. And I'm quitting.
Thank you, Commissioner Richardson. I'm going to call on Commissioner Travis again, if you will. I'd like for you to introduce the winners from Saturday's events.
Thank you. We had some drawings. Every child that came through the event, we put their name in a box, and Sheriff Page drew the names. And Corbin Nance from Eden won two fur skins. Jack Raystrahl from Reevesville won the compound bow. And Ryan Clabot from Reevesville won the Ruger Precision Rifle 22. So it was a very wonderful day. So hopefully next year will be even bigger.
Thank you. Commissioner Berger.
I want to thank the town of Stoneville for having us, and certainly want to recognize some of the elected officials in the room. Our district attorney, Jason Ramey, is here, and appreciate you being in attendance, and certainly appreciate your son leading us in the pledge this evening. Also from the town of Mayodan, we have Bud Cardinal. Bud, I believe your festival is this Saturday. Is that correct?
Yes.
And then Madison is the week after. Town of Stoneville, as far as elected official, we have the mayor that has been introduced, Kathy Stanley Galvin, and also Johnny Farmer. And then school board, we have Bob Wyatt and Doug Isley. And of course, you heard from Bobby Stanley, we certainly appreciate everything that you do for the community and have done in the past. The one thing I want to mention tonight is we are coming up, before you realize it, we're into the holiday season. Our Department of Social Services, they need your help. You can sponsor a child or sponsor an adult that is in foster care. The number to reach out to DSS is 342-1394. To sponsor a child, that extension is 7090. To sponsor an adult, it's 7170. Really, we've got more people than you would ever imagine in foster care. That's both children and adults. And a lot of those folks don't have families that they can count on. That's why they end up in foster care. The littlest things brings a smile, not just to a child's face, but also to an adult's face. So we keep that in mind, reach out to DSS. We've got a little bit of time now, but we are already into October, so we've got a little bit more than 2 months to get as many people sponsored as possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Berger. With that, I want to put a final point on some of the comments that were offered earlier tonight. Since January of 2019 until about July of this year, Rockingham County has received, or promised, been received under contract, $1 billion in additional investment in the county. That's through about 12 projects, industrial projects, which, you know, we've all heard of some of the big ones, but there are some smaller ones as well. And there are four potential projects that are under development for this year that have not been publicly announced. This $1 billion investment in the county is slated to produce 1,562 jobs. And of those 1,500 jobs, all but two of those produce substantially more than our county average for their average pay. Now, in addition to that, we currently have slated over the next 10 years an additional 2,500 homes coming into Rockingham County. That's going to translate into probably about 3,800 children who could potentially attend schools. And these numbers do not include the two subdivisions that we approved at one of our later meetings, which if I'm thinking that's probably about another 150 homes in those two developments. So a lot of good things are happening. So, you know, we appreciate that Rockingham County used to be a powerhouse. Well, guys, based on the last 2 years, we're moving on again. So we appreciate the county's efforts. We appreciate economic development's efforts because you make this county look attractive. So we appreciate that. That being said, again, a reminder on the wall, October 14th through the 17th, Thursday around lunchtime through Sunday at 3 o'clock, around the clock. Please go out and attend this if you can. With that, we will let folks know our next meeting is October 18th in the Governmental Center. And of course, that's a Monday. And we will be in Wentworth for that meeting. So please attend if you can. With that, we will entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Thank you, Commissioner Richardson. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Commissioner Powell. Is that right?
Yes.
Very good. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
We are adjourned.
Thank you.